Hello and welcome back to the Film Reel, your number one source for all your movie and TV news here on News Channel 15. I am Bryce West here with Kane Jones, and we have got an action-packed episode for today. So let's get right into the box office results. At number one was Terminator Dark Fate, but at a disappointing weekend domestic gross of $29 million. Yeesh. It made it to number one, but it didn't make it too far up.
Right.
That is, what are your reactions to this number? Because Joker, I mean, if you look at Joker's opening box office, that was astronomically bigger than that. So
I don't know. I think Terminator just tanked. The critics, they had high hopes.
Well, sadly enough, though, this was the highest praised movie since the second one.
Right. I don't know. Critics, there was just something they weren't digging, you know?
I think, I don't necessarily know if it was a critic thing, but, like, I feel like it kind of was because the last couple movies was critically panned so horribly.
Right.
So I don't really think that people were really looking forward to this movie. Really at all, even though it did get some pretty decent reviews, but both with the critics and the audiences. Joker comes in at number two, still hanging on there.
Right.
It is currently at a worldwide total of $938 million in the box office. I'd say definitely this movie is going to be a $1 billion movie.
Right, that's what I think too.
It's pretty impressive to see. Definitely, because this is a Batman movie. Without Batman in it, it is just the Joker.
Right.
And I definitely did not expect this to be a $1 billion film.
I didn't either.
So,
we
will definitely be reporting whenever it does hit $1 billion. It is right there. It's so close. Maleficent was at number three. Not really a surprise. I think it was quite impressive to see Joker just barely squeak by
it once again because
we had a little bit of a confusion last week where we thought Joker made it back to number one, but it actually was number two just by a very thin margin.
Right.
This time it was at number two by a barely thin margin. Harriet at number four, a little bit of a surprise there.
Right.
I didn't really expect this to make the top five, but a movie about Harriet Tubman and stuff like that made it to number four. So I guess that's really good for the guys who made that movie.
Right.
And coming in at number five was The Addams Family, the kids movie.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it stayed on there.
Yeah.
So a movie that we had reported on that completely bombed. We thought it was going to do well. Jojo Rabbit.
Yeah.
I guess is coming into more theaters because Rotten Tomatoes is reporting it as opening this weekend, and I have been seeing a lot more trailers on YouTube and other stuff like that.
Yeah.
So I have been seeing more of a marketing campaign for this movie. So do you think that it now has a chance with it opening in more theaters and having more of a marketing campaign?
I guess. Like you said, we're just seeing more promotion for it. So yeah, I don't know. I guess we'll see.
So maybe we jumped the gun on our predictions last time, and maybe you will make it to the top five.
Yeah, I'm just as stunned as you are on that.
So
it's
really, really interesting to see.
Right.
So right now we're going to take a look at Dr. Sleep opening this weekend. This is definitely going to be the big blockbuster of the weekend. I am really excited for this movie.
Yep,
I love The Shining. Don't get me wrong, The Shining is a terrifying movie. It gave me nightmares the first time I watched it, but it is
still
definitely
gives me nightmares.
Oh yeah.
If you watch it again.
Yeah, it is a masterpiece.
Oh, yeah.
And to see Ewan McGregor in the role of the little boy now grown up in this movie is really interesting. What are you looking forward to seeing this movie?
Pretty much what you said, like the little kid like all grown up and seeing how he deals with all this this trauma and stuff now.
Yeah.
You know? So yeah.
So do you think that we're going to see, like, I mean, obviously we're going to see some homages to the first film.
Right.
Do you think we're going to see any of Jack Nicholson? I at least maybe not specifically Jack Nicholson in the character, but maybe
similar character, maybe?
Or no, I mean like the character from the first film. Do you think we're going to see him, but maybe played by someone else? I don't think Jack Nicholson is in this movie.
No.
But do you think we're going to see that character?
It is possible. A similar character that could, you know, fill that void this time around, you know?
Yeah, so from what I've heard that they it's not going to be as scary as the first film. Like, it's not, like, specifically horror.
Right.
But it's definitely a continuation of the story. And, I really hope it is. I mean, at least a little scary. I mean, I've heard it's like more trying to go along the lines of thriller instead of just specific horror. Yeah. But like, seeing Ewan McGregor in the role, I mean, he is a fantastic actor. He has got so much coming up
now. Yeah.
So, I mean, he's got this movie. He's got Birds of Prey coming out next year. Mm-hmm. We had reported that on the show.
Right.
Didn't really think it looked that great. But I am super pumped for to see him in this movie. And then he's also going to be in a show on Disney Plus about the character for, his character from Star Wars, Obi-Wan Kenobi, which fans are super excited for.
Right.
And it's really interesting to see... like a Stephen King sequel that's not just like some low budget, like let's make some, make a quick buck off of this. This is actually based off of a book that was written by Stephen King. So this is a real sequel. This isn't some Children of the Corn, like 50 billion sequels. This is a high budget, high quality sequel to The Shining, and we don't always get that.
No.
Because, oh man, that was chilling just watching that right there, him looking through the door. But yeah, this isn't just going to be some slap together nonsense.
Right.
This is going to be a high quality film, and I am definitely really looking forward to seeing this in the theater.
Right.
So yeah, that was our look at Dr. Sleep. We're hoping to see it this weekend, and we're going to take a quick little break, and coming after this, we're going to be having a tribute to a Survivor legend, Rudy Bosch, who was really the sole, almost like the sole reason why the show became popular with his character, along with him and Richard Hatch, really made the first season really, really amazing and what people what got people into the show. So we'll take a quick look at that right after this.
I didn't want to go to community college because it was too small, too limiting.
I wanted a place where I could expand my horizons and gain experiences for a strong future.
Where I could meet people from other places and learn about them.
A college choice that meant a strong start, not huge debt.
Where I would have the support I needed.
Where teachers knew my name and worked with me on a personal level.
And people were ready and available to help me plan my future.
That's why I choose my community college!
Channel 15 is now available on the Roku and Apple TV smart devices. Log on to facebook.com/my15news to learn more.
Here in Southern Illinois, we all know the weather can change in an instant. When severe weather strikes, you can count on the team at News Channel 15 to provide you the latest information to keep you and your family safe. From watches and warnings to storm spotter information with our direct link to the National Weather Service, the team at News Channel 15 is here to give you the most up-to-the-minute severe weather coverage, not only on air, but also online and on our Facebook page. News Channel 15, putting Southern Illinois first.
The Tri-State source for alternative rock is 89.1 The Bash. Connect with us wherever you are on social.
Long ago, it swept away. Poverty used to be this way.
Listen live on our free mobile apps, online, or on TuneIn. We are today's hit alternative, 89.1 The Bash.
So, what's your story? Looking for a cost-effective way to begin your college career? One that's close to home? Or are you still unsure of a career direction? Here's the answer. The four Illinois Eastern Community Colleges. With 100 certificate and associate degrees in career and technical fields, many online and many transferable. Frontier Community, Lincoln Trail, Alney Central, Wabash Valley. Four colleges, one mission. Let us help write your life story. Check us out online at iecc.edu.
Welcome back to The Film Reel, your number one source for your movie and TV news here on News Channel 15. Right now we're going to take a tribute to Rudy Bosch, who was a Survivor legend on the first season of Survivor, and he also came back for the Survivor All-Star season. Here you're going to see some kind of goofy clips, but that's kind of who Rudy was, about him kind of insulting his tribe mates and... basically, there was also a challenge where they were supposed to have all these trivia questions, and he didn't know any of the answers to them. He was a really interesting character and a really fun character to watch on TV, and he was one of the primary reasons that Survivor became so popular right whenever it first came out. Right. So we're going to take a look at that tribute of him right now.
Rain's coming. Again? That's right, I could always use a wash.
Before we got on the island here, I formed opinions about people, but I changed my mind just on that trip in. Rich, for one. I mean, this guy is, he's strong, he's smart, the guy surprises me. You know, he's fat, but he's good.
You can just lay it right over those.
I like Rudy. I'm not bothered by his straightforwardness at all. I don't think it even a problem. I like it that he's saying, hey, do this or hey, do that. But people are thinking of that as very direct and arrogant. That's the word I'm hearing. And I'm thinking to myself, well, they think he's arrogant. Oh, my God, I'm out of here.
Win this, you're going to the final four. Survivor's ready. Go!
Well, the spirit's still in the air to conch show. I don't know. What is the one event that has overshadowed the departure to most of the survivors from Tribal Council? I don't know. If the spirits cause you to become lost in the jungle, what should you do? Find your way home. I don't know.
Hang in there as long as you can. The last person standing gets immunity. And we are now beginning.
Swap.
You take his hand off.
I think that's that, brother.
Yeah. I'm done.
I don't have nothing to say to these two. I just like to let everybody here know how dumb I feel after the mistake I made yesterday.
Okay. Rudy!
What do I look like?
Okay.
Magellan?
Okay.
Take a pot of water back with us.
Okay. No, Rudy, no, we have to boil it, Rudy. 5 minutes.
We'll boil it. You know, I drank bad water all over the world in Vietnam and Russia, and it never bothered me. I drank dirtier stuff than that. And when she works this bow, it causes friction. A lot more friction than that way, you know. I mean, if you want to do it the right way, this is the way.
Well, so that didn't work.
You know, I think me and you ought to think about an alliance.
You're a man of your word, too, from what I know of you.
Yeah.
I am, too.
Tina and Ethan are good buddies.
I know.
The other two are good buddies.
I know.
We could be out of this thing in a hurry.
Yep.
I figured me and Rupert ought to protect ourselves and form an alliance, and that's what we did. He says, I can depend on you, and he says, you can depend on me. That's all I gotta hear.
So as Rudy says, the water's of no value.
Well, I drank it.
Navy SEAL, how wise is that? Is that all right?
Yeah.
So is it wise because it's the other tribe?
Yeah.
There you go.
My foot hurts when I walk. You know, it sort of makes me limp a little. I don't know what's wrong. Probably in a week it'll be back to normal.
What about you, Rudy? What is it about this game that continues to appeal to you? You've survived situations much worse than this.
I really don't know why I'm here again. I'm 3 years slower, that's for sure. But I like it, you know, putting up with the people is a survival part, not putting up with the elements.
How are you hanging in there physically?
Good. I got a sore ankle, but I think it's going away.
Rudy. Two votes, Rudy. Two votes, Ethan. I'll read the last vote.
second person voted out of the Saboga tribe? Rudy, you need to bring me a torch. Rudy, the tribe has spoken. It's time for you to go.
I talked to these people about 2 hours ago, and everything was all set up to vote Ethan off. And I can see Ethan voting against me, but I can't see the other two people voting against me. And if I was them, I'd stay clear of me. I got a lot of friends. That's about all I got to say.
I didn't want to go to community college because it was too small, too limiting.
I wanted a place where I could expand my horizons and gain experiences for a strong future.
Where I could meet people from other places and learn about them.
A college choice that meant a strong start, not huge debt.
Where I would have the support I needed.
Where teachers knew my name and worked with me on a personal level.
And people were ready and available to help me plan my future.
That's why I choose my community college!
Channel 15 is now available on the Roku and Apple TV smart devices. Log on to Facebook.com/My15News to learn more. Here in Southern Illinois, we all know the weather can change in an instant. When severe weather strikes, you can count on the team at News Channel 15 to provide you the latest information to keep you and your family safe. From watches and warnings to storm spotter information with our direct link to the National Weather Service, the team at News Channel 15 is here to give you the most up-to-the-minute severe weather coverage, not only on air, but also online and on our Facebook page. News Channel 15, putting Southern Illinois first. The Tri-State source for alternative rock is 89.1 The Bash. Connect with us wherever you are on social.
All our ghosts get swept away. Continues to be this way.
Listen live on our free mobile apps, online, or on TuneIn. We are today's hit alternative, 89.1 The Bash.
So, what's your story? Looking for a cost-effective way to begin your college career? One that's close to home? Or are you still unsure of a career direction? Here's the answer. The four Illinois Eastern Community Colleges, with 100 certificate and associate degrees in career and technical fields, many online and many transferable. Frontier Community, Lincoln Trail, Alney Central, Wabash Valley. Four colleges, one mission. Let us help write your life story. Check us out online at iecc.edu.
Welcome back to the Film Reel, your number one source for your movie and TV news. Here on News Channel 15, I'm Bryce West, here with Kane Jones. Right now, we're going to take a look at some upcoming trailers for some movies coming out here in the future. Let's take a look.
So, what's your plan, Mr. Garrett?
How would you like to buy a bank?
What the hell do we know about banking?
Owning a bank is like owning the other side of the real estate business.
There's a few complexities you just left out.
Like what?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I not wake up black this morning? Because I'm pretty sure I did. Yep, still black.
I got my head full of dreams.
I came here to try my hand at real estate.
You mad at millionaire units?
You know the time never sleeps.
I like seeing black men succeed. Sometimes I even invest some of my own money to back them. I know you're smart and ambitious.
You and I both know that's not enough.
It's time that someone shine a bright light in order for things to change.
Are you starting to buy real estate in white-only neighborhoods?
Keep one eye open.
Think about all the good we can do for the community.
Taking it to the man.
That's exactly what we're going to do.
And just how in the hell do you plan on pulling that off?
We get Matt to front for us.
You want me to what?
Be us to the rest of the world.
We can't set foot in the bank unless we the help. Should have took limo driver when you had the chance.
I don't know anything about banking. I don't know how to buy a bank.
We'll teach you everything you need to know.
You gotta learn how to talk to rich white folks like you one of them.
And you can't fake a golf game.
Make me proud, son.
Whole country's talking about how two Negroes managed to buy two banks full of white folks' money and loan it to other Negroes.
You should have known you couldn't keep this a secret very long.
FBI, you're under arrest.
A black man tries to bring other brothers up. That's intolerant.
Oh, when you're working on faith. Oh, when you're living on faith. Something's got to give. Something's got to give.
Even a rig gang's fun to play by now.
If this was easy, somebody else would have done it a long time ago.
Something's got to give.
You're a revolutionary.
This is a whole new thing. Nobody told us we had to do a whole new thing.
Okay, something went wrong.
Come on.
I'm coming.
Grandpa Eddie?
Morning.
Did you guys see Spencer?
Who's that? I think he went back in. We gotta go get him.
You know something?
Thanks.
We haven't even picked our guys yet.
Are we in Florida?
Oh, my God.
Wait.
We're in the wrong body!
My joints feel like butter.
Oh, no. I feel loose myself.
This can't be happening!
I came back and things actually got worse.
Look at this.
One, two, three.
We have some issues here. The game is busted!
Listen up now. This is a dangerous place. You've got to have eyes in the back of your head!
What in the Sam hell just happened to him?
What the hell is this?
Would you look at me? I haven't looked like this since...
Never. You look like this never.
I think my eyes are a different color.
All of you is a different color.
Check this out. Strengths and weaknesses. Linguistics.
Oh, goodness.
Nunchucks. That's new.
Damn, that's a good list.
Weaknesses. Heat, sun, and sand. How is this guy a character in an adventure game? Man, it is hot out here!
We have to find Spencer and Bethany.
This next adventure is even more challenging. This time, not all of you will leave the game alive.
Bethany thought you might need some help.
Where is Bethany?
She's right here.
She says, oh my God, like I'm a total horse.
Yep, that's Bethany.
Hey!
A terrible driver.
What are you talking about? I just passed my driver's test last month again. We're not going to make it.
We're going to make it.
I don't think we're going to make it.
We're going to make it.
We're not going to make it.
What happened?
Yes, I'm back. I missed you so much. Oh, my God, you guys, hi.
Bethany?
You guys, we're back in Jumanji.
Welcome back to the film reel. So those were two trailers, The Banker and Jumanji. Kane, what did you think about those two trailers?
The Banker obviously looks awesome. Yeah. Anthony Mackie, Sam Jackson, classic. I think it's going to be a real cool movie, a cool story there mm-hmm. that's told. Yeah, what do you think about The Banker?
I think The Banker looks amazing.
Yeah.
I am really looking forward to seeing that movie kind of come together. It's just such an interesting story. It's based off of true events. You have Sam Jackson, Anthony Mackie, Nicholas Holt, you know, an all-star cast.
Right.
I mean, and it's just such a cool story.
Yeah.
Like, about some African Americans back in the day, like trying to make it as bankers.
Right.
And it's just such a really cool story. Like, it's not often we see movies like this, and it's really cool to see right. kind of the development yeah. of that. Oh, obviously, yeah. us oh, yeah. being younger, right. we didn't live through the whole no. civil rights movement, right? So this is like kind of like new for kids like us, right? right? And or like a little bit older and stuff mm-hmm. like that. So it's really interesting to see stories like this
yeah.
because and, like, we didn't get to see it. I mean, yeah. we just got to like learn about it and right. hear about it, but to see it in an actual film form to right. actually get to see it, I think that's really interesting.
And part of it for me is like, if Sam Jackson's in it, I'm gonna go see it.
Yeah.
Because he's Sam Jackson.
Yeah.
So, but Jumanji.
Yeah, yeah.
That was the other one. I personally think it's gonna be cool. I don't know if it'll live up to the first one exactly, but having Danny DeVito and Danny Glover in there, having the old them in the younger versions of yeah. themselves, I think that may be a cool twist on mm-hmm. this franchise that may be a cool perspective that we haven't seen.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be quite the funny movie. Our board yeah. op really got a kick out of that trailer back there. So do you think, I mean, the first film made a lot of money.
Right.
And it went up against Star mm. Wars.
Oh, yeah.
And it still made almost $1 billion.
Right.
Do you think that this one, going up against Star Wars again, will make as much, or do you think it will make more or less?
It's hard to say. I think it has the potential to make $1 billion. I don't know if it will. I think it'll come close. It'll definitely come real close. But yeah.
Well, so we got some more film news for you guys coming in. Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse yeah, 2 yeah. announced. Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse was nominated, mm-hmm. won yeah. the Oscar yeah, for won. Best Animated yeah. Picture.
Mm-hmm.
Quite the achievement.
Oh, yeah.
And they are coming back with a sequel, of mm-hmm. course, because why would they not?
Right.
Yeah. And but the only problem is that it's going to be in spring of 2022, which is a little bit far off.
That's okay.
But
that's okay.
These animated movies take a little while to make.
Right, yeah.
You know, so I'm really looking forward to this movie. Do you think that this sequel will live up to the critical acclaim of the first?
I do. I think it will on this one because the first one was a perspective of Spider-Man we've never seen because we've never had an animated spider flick that has done well like that.
Yeah.
So I think this one definitely is gonna do as well, if not greater.
Yeah.
At the box office.
Oh, at the box office, yeah. I definitely think it's going to do way better.
Oh, yeah.
It's coming out in spring, yeah. which it's not going up against. It was going up right, against right. Aquaman, Bumblebee, yeah. like mm-hmm. all those huge blockbuster
heavy
movies
hitters, yeah.
at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
so that kind of, I mean, it still made a profit, but it only right. made like around like $300 million mm-hmm. worldwide, right. I'm pretty sure. But this, I definitely think, is going to make way mm-hmm. more money than the first.
Right.
And yeah. so I definitely think that people awesome. Should be oh, excited yeah. mm-hmm. for spring
for
of 2022.
Sure,
What do you think the story is going to be like? Because we've already seen the multiverse, right?
Right,
we already know that there's those characters out there. How do you think that they can really change it to make it sort of different?
I think that going down the line, there will be a new villain possibly introduced, and just explore the multiverse further. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying?
Kinda. Yeah.
I don't know.
What kind of different Spider-Man, Spider-People, I guess, do you think we could see? Because we could see, like, some weird ones, like the Japanese Spider-Man or the original
right.
animated Spider-Man. Or, like, we could have so many weird Spider-People.
I mean, wherever the director decides to go with it, you know. But, yeah, it's really hard to say. I mean, there's several options that they could... several paths that they could take, you know.
Yeah.
So I don't know. It's hard to say. I guess we'll see.
Yeah, it will be definitely really interesting to see Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse
yeah.
2 comes out in spring
yep.
of 2022. In other news, Fantastic Beasts 3 is announced to be filming and filming next year in 2020. Mm-hmm. And people are not necessarily so surprised, but the second one was the lowest grossing Harry Potter film so far,
right.
and it was critically panned, rightfully so, because
yeah.
honestly, I believed that it was a terrible movie.
Yeah.
The story was all okay, but like the
yeah.
whole pacing of the film and
yeah.
and like the editing of the film, I thought
right.
was just terrible.
Yeah.
Like, I hated that movie.
Like, I love Harry Potter,
yeah.
but, like, these spinoff movies, I don't know. I just think they're, it's like, Harry's not in them.
Yeah.
So, like, it's kind of plummeting.
See, I
like,
don't know, though, because I really liked the first film.
The first one was good. I'll give you that.
And so, it'll be, I don't know. It's just weird. I'm looking forward to it. Like, Johnny Depp was great in the role, but I don't know if it's really going to do all that well. Coming in with our box office predictions for this weekend, at number one, I have Dr. Sleep, obviously the new movie coming out. Number two, I have Terminator. It could be Joker. I don't know. Mm-hmm. It's just Terminator's newer, so I put it there. At number three, I have Joker. Mm-hmm. And at number four, I have Maleficent. And at number five, I have The Last Christmas, which has Emilia Clarke in it, and I've been seeing a lot of trailers for it. What is your top five?
A little different. Number one, Dr. Sleep, sequel to The Shining. I think that'll be number one. Terminator coming at two, huge blockbuster. But Last Christmas with Emilia Clarke, I think, is going to squeeze in to the third spot. And Joker, number four, followed by Jojo Rabbit, which you forgot.
It could be. It could be. Thank you guys so much for watching. To News Channel 15, I'm Bryce West. That's Kane Jones. Thank you. Take care.